After picking up her two sons on September 23rd, 2011, Janice Spencer visits a fast food restaurant in hopes of grabbing a quick dinner for her family.
Three Western barbecue burger combos, thanks.
Thank you.
But as she checks the contents of the bag, she realizes they have gotten her order wrong.
We didn't get these, Mom.
Okay, we'll do it again.
After explaining the mix-up, the employee refills the order. But to her bewilderment, the fast food chain has gotten the order wrong again.
I don't understand what's wrong with you. Did you check it?
Did you order that?
After sending the food back a third and then fourth time,
I don't understand.
Tempers start to flare.
Yeah. I'm at a drive-thru right now.
Uh-huh.
I asked them four different times to make me a Western barbecue burger. Okay, they keep giving me a hamburger with lettuce, tomato, and cheese, onions. And I said, I'm not leaving. She gave me another hamburger. It's wrong.
Food dispute 911 calls are troublesome because they take up time.
I asked them four different times.
They take up opportunities for other people with real emergencies to call in.
Not everybody gets everything they want. Sometimes you can't have the perfect burger.
I said four times. I said, no, I want my hamburger right. So my kids are hungry and I have to jump on the toll freeway. I said, I am not leaving this spot. And I said, I will call the police because I want my Western burger done right. Now, is that so hard?
This gal has no concept of reality, has no concept of what we're supposed to be used for. She needs to figure out that the priority in her life is not a hamburger.
Okay, what exactly is it you want us to do for you?
I send the officers down here. I want them to make...
Ma'am, we're not going to go down there and enforce your Western bacon cheeseburger.
What am I supposed to do?
This is between you and the manager. We're not going to go enforce how to make a hamburger. That's not a criminal issue. There's nothing criminal.
So I just sit here and
block. You need to calmly and rationally speak to the manager and figure out what to do between you.
She did come up and I said, can I please have my Western burger? She said, I'm not doing it. She walked away.
Ma'am, then I suggest you get your money back and go somewhere else. This is not a criminal issue. We can't go out there and make them make you a cheeseburger the way you want it.
You're supposed to be here to protect me.
Well, what are we protecting you from, a wrong cheeseburger?
No.
Is this a harmful cheeseburger or something? I don't understand what you want us to do.
Well, just come down here. I'm not leaving.
You know, I understand that not everybody gets what constitutes an emergency call or not. And I know that maybe she's got her kids screaming at her and she's tired, but what does she really think we're going to do? Are we going to come and arrest the people that are there because they didn't make the burger the way she wanted it?
No, ma'am, I'm not sending the deputies down there over a cheeseburger. You need to go in there and act like an adult and either get your money back and go home.
Stop acting like an adult herself.
Ma'am, this is what I suggest. I suggest you get your money back from the manager and you go on your way home.
Okay.
Okay? Bye-bye.
Fine.
This is one of those instances where the customer is not always right.
While the dispatcher did cut the call short, she did not send the police to the scene. Janice finally got a refund and an apology from the corporate offices.
911. I got seven cows out loose, maybe going highway.
Okay, ma'am, you need to...
Everybody know that there are loose cows out there.
Why are you yelling at me?
Because I tried to call before, and you guys said it wasn't an emergency. And
no, ma'am, we will have a deputy come out there.
February 13th, 2009. Tony Marks of Branson, Missouri, spends his Friday night with a couple of beers while he browses the internet on his laptop. Beside him, his wife of 32 years lies fast asleep. But a careless misstep by Tony wakes her, and the two are immediately at odds with one another.
What's the emergency?
Hello, I'm sitting here on my computer, and my wife's sitting here beside me, and I done gave her like two or three beers. She won't go to bed.
No, I'm not.
When it comes to domestic disturbance calls, we want to determine, first of all, is there any violence going on?
Have both of you been drinking?
She won't leave me alone. I'm sitting here trying to be on the steer, and she won't go to bed until I give her some beer. And she's drunk.
So that you don't drink it.
One thing you'll hear oftentimes, especially people under the influence of alcohol, is they'll over-exaggerate. And they'll create, in their minds, more of a problem and more of a situation that's actually true. So it's something that we have to weed through to find out what the actual truth is.
Okay, are you guys still on the phone or are you just sitting that close to each other?
But she's sitting right next to me.
I'll call
you. Would you shut up?
There wasn't anything serious or dangerous that happened in this situation, but any domestic situation always has the potential to blow up. Even something as small as not wanting to go to bed. You just never know what the next turn could be.
Why did you actually call 911, sir?
Because I wanted to have them come out and tell her to go to bed.
How much has you guys had to drink?
I went and got a 12-pack, and I gave her 3. She was irate because I won't give her any more because she's drunk.
Have you had anything to drink, sir?
Yes.
How much have you had to drink?
A lot.
People call 911 to resolve their relationship drama all the time. They just want someone to listen, someone to hear them out.
You guys not being able to handle your marriage isn't considered an emergency, just so you know.
We've been married for 32 years, ma'am. So I just wanted a calm evening, some beer, and do my Facebook.
I am not going to bed.
Well, there's a cop out there right now.
Go ahead and just talk to the deputies over there.
He's drunk, officer. He's so drunk.
Well, which one of you called 911?
They say you should never go to bed mad, but that doesn't mean you should call the police for backup.
Tony explains the issue to the police. The officer gives Tony a warning and recommends the couple seek counseling.